Are you a visual learner, auditory, or hands-on? Turns out, none of the above. Hey guys, Julia here for DNews. I've always thought of myself as a kind of hands-on learner. I learn better when I can do things with what I've learned. That's why experiments are one of my favorite parts about science classes. You get to test what you've learned by applying it. Meshing is the idea that a teacher should match their teaching style to a kid's individual learning style, like using flashcards for those who are visual learners. Basically, treat kids like the special snowflakes they are and poof, all their school troubles will go away. But not so fast. The topic of learning styles is super complicated. I mean, there's supposedly a lot of learning styles out there. One study from the Learning and Skills Research Center in London found over 70 different types. Most of those are constructed as dichotomous, with opposing concepts like visual learners versus auditory, that sort of thing. So it's hard to pinpoint what exactly we mean when we talk about learning styles. That's one of the problems. Another problem? There's not a lot of empirical evidence to support learning styles at all. Sure, it's been studied, but most studies aren't well designed. The journal Psychological Science in the Public Interest found a lack of sound studies of learning styles. The authors looked for a rigorous approach to testing the validity of claims that learning styles matter. They laid down requirements for a thorough investigation, divided people up based on their supposed learning style, randomly assigned them whatever method of instruction, then test all the students. Basically, the authors were looking for an experiment that revealed a specific type of interaction between learning style and instructional method. So the students who were assigned their performed method should perform better on the test. They looked at lots of different studies and found that lots of people will proclaim some type of preferred educational experience, but what they found was nilch, nada. Basically, of all the studies that are out there, most rely on self-reporting for determining someone's learning style. Self-reporting isn't really the most scientifically rigorous. Those studies that were somewhat better had contradicting results. But that's not to say it's totally junk. The researchers even caution that they aren't saying the same manner of instruction works for all students in all situations. People do differ in personality, temperament, and ability. No one is doubting that. Treating students as individuals probably won't hurt them. So what's the best way to teach a subject? Well, depends on the subject. The authors of the study used the example of teaching writing. Of course, it's going to be a heavily verbal course, and something like geometry is going to use a lot of visuals to aid in learning. As for the best way to teach a student, well, one study published in the journal Educational Psychologist found that people who are new to a subject learn differently than those who have more expertise. In what's called the expertise reversal effect, learning something new can overwhelm someone's working memory. They don't have any prior knowledge or experience to draw upon, so they need more guidance. On the other hand, those who are experts or more knowledgeable about a subject might be harmed by too much guidance. People without a lot of experience learn better by looking at examples and being guided through those. And those with more experience need to be more hands-on. It's better for them if they solve problems by themselves. Other studies show that engaging students is the best way to go. One study published in the journal Science found that a way to teach called deliberate practice helped students do twice as well on a test and increased attendance by 20%. The trick? This practice relies less on lectures and focuses more on the students. Students are first asked what they know about a subject in a short multiple choice test, and they are encouraged to discuss what they think they know with other students. Then once the teacher understands what the students might know or might actually be wrong about, they are better able to deal with it and address those problems directly. I mean, I'd much rather a teacher get right to the stuff I have questions about than spend a whole boring class period going over material I already understand. And really, learning is so hard anyways. All that overthinking actually makes it more difficult to learn. Crystal has the scoop on that in this episode right here.
Children learn way faster than adults because they're not subject to this cortical control. They can't overthink because their judgy frontal cortex hasn't even been developed yet. This is one reason why kids are more creative and frequently take risks than an adult probably wouldn't.
So what do you think? What is your favorite way to learn? Tell us about it down in the comments below. Don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back to DNews. We've got new episodes every single day.